Good morning, everyone. It is 7:48 a.m. on Monday morning. I've actually been up for quite a while now. I don't sleep too well at night. I just finished watching Scott Crusher's live stream, The Muted Jets. That was fun. I finally got to catch one live. But yeah, I figured I'd do a vlog, or maybe I'll do a vlog. I don't know if I'm going to upload any of this or not. We'll see. So yeah, it is Monday morning, the 18th. Let's go ahead and update our calendar first. Oh boy. So yeah. There we go. Alright. So I actually found two movies I'm going to watch. One of them I'm going to watch this morning. I've seen it before, but it's been a while. It's called The Wraith. And another one is Warcraft. I never watched it, so I'm getting them loaded on the flash drive here. I need dust, man. This is all dusty. So while that's getting on the flash drive, I have to go take my morning meds. Take 3 in the morning, 4 at night. Yay, heart failure. Oh, man. Good news is the swelling in my feet is going down, but my legs are still a little swollen. They're edemic, and which means is basically if you take your finger and you press down on my leg, it'll have an imprint, and it stays there for a few minutes. So it's weird looking. I'm not going to do it because it freaks me out. But it's because of fluid buildup. Now in the morning, I have to take Eliquis, which is my blood thinner. This is Lasix. It's a diuretic. It's makes me pee. Or supposed to make me pee. And it's supposed to get rid of all the built-up fluid in my body. And this is, I don't know if I'm saying this right, Carvedilol. It's supposed to treat heart failure, prevent stroke, heart attack, and all that good stuff. So these are the 3 I have to take every morning, and then I take them again at night, plus another one that's basically Lipitor. So yeah, let me take these and I'll be right back. Alright, taking my morning meds. I'm good to go until tonight. I usually try to take around 8 in the morning and around 8 at night. Just 12 hours apart. Good morning, Bella. Good morning, pretty girl. Bella sleeps on the bed with me every night now. She does not sleep in her recliner anymore. I'm sorry, y'all just gotta get used to the coughing. It's the fluid buildup that gets in my lungs. So she doesn't sleep on a recliner anymore. I bought this new blanket, and she likes it more than she does the recliner. So she, at night, she either lays on the bed with me or she sleeps right here on the ottoman. I've got the ottoman right there, and I've got 2 thick blankets over it, so it's nice and soft for her. So yeah, that's what she does. She sleeps on the bed with me now, which I'm not complaining. I love that little cat. Alright, so the movies have been transferred. So, give me a second. I'll be right back. Let me shut the PC down. Alright, we've got our trusty flash drive. I have to put this out by the front door for the mailman to pick up. I sold some slip covers on eBay. I never knew there was a market for slip covers. Whenever I buy movies, I always used to throw the slip covers away, but apparently there is a market for slip covers and people buy them. So I sold, I think this is 6 4K slip covers. So I'll just leave this out by the front door so the mailman can pick it up and it'll be on its way. So give me a minute, I'll be right back. Alright, package is by the door, so the mailman will come pick it up. Let me grab my phone. Not that I'm going to use it, but just keep it out there just in case. Oops, forgot to hit the switch, turn the computer off. Okay. Yeah. Go ahead and cook some breakfast. And if you've been watching lately, you know exactly what I'm going to cook. And yes, I'm going to film it again. I'm sure there's at least one person out there that enjoys watching me cook eggs. If not, feel free to fast forward. Oh, man. Alright. It's my journal I write in every night. Whew, I need to stop walking at normal. I need to stop trying to walk so fast. I'm getting worn out. It's like I take things nice and slow, but sometimes I try to walk normal speed or a little faster, and it just wears me out, man. I'm definitely not ready for normal speed yet. Let me get everything together, and I'll be back. We'll start cooking breakfast. Alright, we got the pan heating up. We have our unsalted butter. Oh, Lord. Alright, let me put this down. Alright, there we go. That was hard to do one-handed, man. Like I said, the only reason I put the butter in the pan is so the eggs don't stick to the pan. I've tried to cook the eggs. Like, just crack the eggs into the pan, and they stick to it. So, alright, let me put the camera down while I crack these eggs. I'll be back. And there we go. Hopefully we can get those eggs flipped over and out without breaking the yolk. We'll see. Start the toast. And, yeah, let's go ahead and get our movie booted up here. Hi, baby Bella. Hello, my sweet girl. Hi, pretty girl. Hi, pretty girl. Love you, Bella. You're my good girl. Yeah. You're my good girl. Yes, you are. I don't have a disc this morning, Bella. No, I'm sorry, I don't have a disc. Ugh, that nasty ass carpet, man. Ugh, that carpet is embarrassing. That's why I try not to film the carpet, man. It is embarrassing. It's so nasty. Oh, Bella. Yeah. It's nasty, bitch. Oh, man. Oh, yeah. Legs still a little bit swollen. Well, a lot swollen. And they're edemic. Like I said, if I take my finger and press down, you'll see the indentation up there for quite a while. I'm not going to do it, though. Because it freaks me out. It looks so disgusting. Hey, Bella. Hello, my sweet cat. Alright, let's go to movies. The Wraith. It's been years since I've seen this. Hi, Bella. Hey, pretty girl. So, I'm going to try to flip these eggs over without breaking the yolk. Give me a minute, I'll be back. Mission accomplished. Managed to flip the eggs over and get them on the plate without breaking the yolk. Got our pieces of toast. Let's get a fork. Ugh. I hate that. Alright. Ugh. Yeah, I hate that. And sometimes I cough so hard I start dry heaving, which sucks. All right. Oh. All right, I want to watch our movie, eat our breakfast. How long has this been? It was an hour and a half. Yeah. I'll see you in an hour. Well, it'll be an hour and a half for me. It'll be a second for you. All right, everyone. The movie is over. It is 9:45 a.m. I think I'm going to go take a hot shower and then take a nap. Bella's ready for a nap. She came and got me. She's waiting at the end of the hallway. So Bella's ready for a nap. I think I am too, but I'm going to take a shower first. So yeah, I will see y'all a little bit later. Feel better. Had a nice hot shower, brushed my teeth. I'm good to go, man. Bella's ready for a nap, though. Yeah, baby Bella's ready for a nap. I might try to stay up a little bit longer, just so I can try to sleep longer at night. I don't sleep well at night now. I wake up every 1 to 2 hours having to use the bathroom because of that pill I take. And then my 4:30, 5 in the morning, I can't fall asleep because one of the things that goes on with my heart failure is leg pain. And so 4:30, 5 o'clock, my legs hurt so much that I just have to get up for a couple hours and then go back to sleep. Usually what I do is I'll wait, after I get up to go to the bathroom. I start, when I go to bed, I lay on my right side. I go to the bathroom first time, I come back to bed, I'll lay on my left side. And I'll switch every time I come back from the bathroom. But by 4:30, 5 o'clock, it gets to the point where they just hurt no matter what. So I just stay up for a few hours. I'll take my meds, cook breakfast, and then go back to bed, take a nap. But yeah, and then even when I take a nap in the afternoon, I wake up every 1 to 2 hours. So, yeah, I just want to sleep for 8 hours straight instead of this whole waking up every 1 to 2 hours. I mean, I get my 8 hours of sleep, but it's not all at once. It's spread out through the day. You see, I'm yawning now. But, yeah, as far as the health update goes... Sorry, Bella. I really don't have anything. Like I said earlier in the video, my feet are nowhere near as swollen as they used to be, which is good. The swelling in my feet is going down. Now, if I can just get the swelling in my legs to go down, that'd be awesome. That's pretty much it. I don't have an appointment with a cardiologist until next month, April 18th. I was supposed to go 2 to 4 weeks after I was released from the hospital, but the soonest they could fit me in was April 18th, so yay. So hopefully we get good news. Man, because I'll tell you what, I mean, for the most part, I've been staying positive about this whole situation, but... Sometimes I lose it, man. Sometimes I just lose it. And I'll be honest with y'all, I'm not embarrassed to admit, I'll break down and cry like a baby. Because I get tired of it, man. I mean, for those of you who've been with me for a number of years, back in 2018, I had stage 3 colon cancer. I had to deal with that. Stage 3 colon cancer, now significant heart failure. And a clot in my heart. I mean, I'm like, what? Why? Why does this keep happening to me? That's what I keep thinking about. why does this stuff keep happening to me? Why am I always dealing with these life-threatening medical issues? It's frustrating, man. I'm like, I like to think I've been a good person in my life, doing everything right, and for what? Hey, you've been doing everything you're supposed to do in life. Here's stage 3 cancer. Hey, you beat cancer, you've been doing everything right, you're a good guy, here's heart failure. It's just, I don't know, man, I don't know. It gets to me sometimes, man. I snap out of it, but man, it gets to me sometimes. Looking at my leg, I was resting my fingers on my leg, and now I've got, you know, finger indentations in my fingers on my leg. It's freaking me out. Yeah, man, I get frustrated. I get frustrated when I see people who have no medical issues at all pretending that they do just so they can get attention. That pisses me off, man. Like people who pretend to have medical issues just so they can get people feeling sorry for them and give them attention. That's pathetic, man. Like how low can you go? You are shit on the bottom of someone's boot. And stuff like that pisses me off. There are people in the world actually dealing with life-threatening medical issues, and you got people pretending that there's something wrong with them when there's really not. And it pisses me off, all because they want some attention. It's ridiculous, man. But anyway, yeah. So the mailman hasn't come yet, but the package is still on the front door, so... First thing I've sold on eBay since I've been in the hospital, I think I sold one other thing. But yeah, when I was in the hospital, of course I sold a bunch of stuff. I had no way to ship it out, so what I had to do was I had to cancel all the orders and give everyone a refund and explain to them, no, I'm in the hospital, I don't know how long I'm going to be here, I have no way of shipping you this stuff, so that's why I'm refunding your money. Everyone was okay with it except for one person. One person got pissed off. Well, I never asked for a refund. I want the item I paid for. I said, once again, I am in the hospital with heart failure. I don't know how long I'm going to be here. I can't ship you your item. That's why I refunded your money. So then he responded, well, I have 100% feedback and I would never behave this way. I want the item I paid for. And so finally I got pissed off. I said, look, motherfucker, you're not getting the item that has already been refunded. I'm not going to tell you again. Your item has been refunded because I am in the hospital and I can't send it to you. I said, I don't know what you don't understand about that, but get it through your head. I can't ship it to you. I gave you your money back. You're not getting anything. Goodbye. And then I blocked him. So, of course, he left negative feedback and said that I never explained why I canceled his order. He never mentioned that I refunded. He just said I canceled it out of nowhere and never gave him an explanation. Bragged about how he paid for it in less than 60 seconds, which was a lie. He paid for it a day later. And then sellers like, this is the worst, and blah, blah, blah. I'm like, oh, my God, what a fucking idiot. So, yeah. God. And so I clicked on his page because he bought some clothes from me. That's what he tried to buy. He's a reseller. He resells the clothes that he buys for 3 times as much. So I think that's the real reason he was mad, because he couldn't flip it for 3 times what he paid for. So screw him. I blocked him. Took the negative feedback. Whatever, man. Couldn't care less. What an idiot. I've had a lot of idiots lately on eBay. A lot of idiots. I had one person get mad at me because I rejected their best offer. I had put those slip covers up on auction. Starting auction, $10. I kid you not, 10 minutes after I listed it, someone sent me an offer for $5, which I thought I had turned best offer off, but apparently not. So I was like, man, it's only been like an hour or two, man. I'm like, yeah. I don't know. I'm not going to take an offer for half of what I listed it for, and it hasn't even been a full day yet, so I declined it. Then he sent me, why would you put an offer? Why would you say you're accepting offers if you're not going to accept them? I'm like, oh my God. So I had to explain to this numbnuts that I don't have to accept his offer, and so he can go get mad somewhere else. So I blocked him. Then I happened to click on his page, and he's a reseller of slipcovers. So, yeah, he was selling slipcovers for $17 a piece, but offered me $5 for six. I tell you, man, eBay is, ugh, God. If there is an easier way to sell this stuff, I would. I do not trust Facebook Marketplace at all, because there, I mean, you think there's idiots on eBay. There are some truly stupid people on Facebook Marketplace. Amazon, you have to pay a monthly fee just to sell stuff up there. I think it's $40 a month just to be able to sell up there, which is asinine. Etsy, you have to pay a monthly fee. So I'm like, ugh. Yeah, whatever. I only have a few things listed on eBay right now, so we'll see what happens. I stopped doing auctions. I would get people that seconds before the auction would end, they'd put in the winning bid and either would never pay for it or they go 4 days before they paid for it. And I'm like, if you're going to put in the winning bid seconds before it's over, it shouldn't take you 4 days to pay. I'm sorry. So now I just do buy it now, because the auctions are a waste of time. Because if someone screws you over on an auction and doesn't pay for it, you got to list it all over again and hope someone bids on it and actually pays. So yeah, I don't do auctions anymore, man. That those slip covers were the last auction I did. Hey, Bella, you're ready for a nap, aren't you, pretty girl? You're my sweet cat. You're a sweet girl. Yes, you are. I love that little cat. So yeah, it's 10:37 now. I might get on the PC, see if I can find some movies to watch. I'll probably end up going back to bed and taking a nap. I know I will. I'm getting sleepy. So anyway, my ranting is over. Go ahead and get that out of the way. Excuse me. Yeah. So let me get on the PC, see if I can find some movies, and I will see you all in a bit. p.m. I went back to bed at 12, so yeah, got a little bit of sleep. I feel rested up. So I'm gonna go back out front here, gonna watch the other movie I put on the was it thumb drive? That's the word I'm looking for. Good lord. Gonna watch the other movie I put on the thumb drive this morning, Warcraft. I haven't seen that, but first I'm gonna go ahead and wash the dishes from breakfast. Get those out of the way. It's my least favorite part of cooking is washing dishes. Hi, Bella. And yes, Bella slept on the bed with me. My baby Bella. Hey, pretty girl. Oh, boy. Yeah. So, not a whole lot to wash. It's not bad. It's definitely been worse. So let me wash these dishes and I'll be back with y'all. Alright, the dishes are done. Unfortunately, this thing has decided to start leaking the past week. And you have to put it in just the right spot for it to stop, and the spot changes all the time. I have not found the spot right now, so he's just leaking non-stop. It is pissing me off. So anyway, screw it, man. It's always something in this house. Nothing ever works like it's supposed to. Alright. Anyway. Oh boy. It's about 3:45. Let's go ahead and see if this movie's any good. Like I said, I've never watched the Warcraft movie, so we'll I'm gonna give it a shot. Oh my goodness. If it ends up that it sucks, there's something else I can watch on the A&E app. A&E every Sunday night has a biography of WWE legends. And last night they did Diamond Dallas Page, and it goes on their app on Mondays. So if Warcraft sucks, I'll go ahead and just put on the A&E app and watch the DDP documentary. Alright. Got a couple horror movies up here too that I haven't seen. I watched Lean on Me last week with Morgan Freeman. That was really good. I enjoyed that one. Summer Rental with John Candy. The Wraith was good. Alright, let's check out Warcraft. Oh boy. I guess we'll start cooking dinner about 5. I'm just gonna throw something together. I'm still experimenting, seeing what I can make that I can actually have that tastes good. So I have to do the low sodium diet, but on top of that, I'm diabetic, so I have to watch how much sugar I have too. So kind of like a double-edged sword. Oh God, I hate that coughing, man. That fluid buildup. It's even worse when I lay down. Like, when I go to bed and I lay down, oh my Lord, I'm coughing for like 5 minutes straight. But anyway, I want to check out Warcraft here, see if it's any good. So we'll either finish Warcraft or we'll watch the documentary on Diamond Dallas Page. We'll see what happens. Alright, folks, it is 5:03 p.m., so we want to cook dinner. All I can come up with tonight is just cooking some egg noodles and mixing them with no salt added tomato sauce. I've got shredded mozzarella cheese, but it has too much sodium in it, so I can't have it. So just going to be noodles and sauce. I might sprinkle a little bit of mozzarella up there, but not a whole lot. So we got our pot of water. I'm going to turn that on high. Do not put any salt in the water. And we're just going to let that come to a boil. So yeah, this will be interesting. We'll see how this turns out. Hopefully it'll be all right. I might put some seasoning in there. Yeah, you know what? Let's get some Italian seasoning in there. There it is. Put some Italian, we'll put some seasonings in there. See if we can spice it up a little bit. But yeah, wait for this water to boil and I'll be back. All right, you've got the noodles in. I'm gonna let these cook for a little while. I'll turn the heat down so I can just let them cook. And I'll come back every once in a while and stir them around so they don't stick to the bottom of the pot. But yeah, we'll cook these. Then we're done, we'll add our tomato sauce and our Italian seasoning, maybe some oregano or something, and we'll see how it turns out. But yeah, we'll let these noodles cook and we'll be back to put our creation together. Alright, so I think the noodles are done cooking, so we'll dump the water out, we'll add our sauce, our seasonings, and we'll see what we can come up with. So give me a few minutes, let me get everything set up. Mama's home, y'all. We got the noodles cooking, so we're gonna add our tomato sauce now. I was gonna put some Italian seasoning and some other stuff in it and try to give it some flavor.
There's no sodium in the Italian season.
I didn't know what other seasonings I could use. Alright. Give me a minute. I'm going to empty these cans and get our seasoning in there. I'll be right back. Alright, we dumped our 2 cans of tomato sauce in. We've got our Italian seasoning in there. I'm just going to mix this all up and we'll see what happens. And Mom would like everyone to know that she is officially on vacation now. So, hey. I'll be right back. Alright, there we go. There's the finished product. I did add a little bit of shredded mozzarella cheese, mixed it in there. But we'll give it a taste and see if it's a keeper. So anyway, back out in the front, we'll finish Warcraft and we'll find something to do. Alright everyone, it is 9:50 p.m. Back in the room now. I'm gonna get on the PC. Probably play some 7 Days to Die. I love that game. It's a zombie survival game. Basically build your own shelters, get your own food, water, supplies, weapons, all that stuff. It's fun. I'll show you a little bit of it right now. But that's what I'm gonna do for a little while. Just play some 7 Days to Die. Got the PC booted up. Alright. Alright, so here we are. Like I said, you have to build your own shelter or bases, as they call it. This is my little base that I threw together. Believe it or not, those are all spikes, and those will, as you can see, kill you. And sometimes the zombies drop loot, ammo, food, supplies, whatever. Drinks. This is a building I built just for all my extra stuff. I left the door unlocked. If any other players come across, I can just go in there and take everything. Because I don't need them. The hell did you come? Yeah, okay. For some reason, every time I log into this server, it's nighttime. Every time. And at nighttime is when the zombies are out in full force, or mostly full force. And then every 7 days, you'll see up top it says day 962. Every 7 days, excuse me, Jesus, at 2200 hours to 4 a.m., you'll get a non-stop wave of zombies at your base, just absolutely try and destroy everything. But yeah, this is my base. That leads down into it. We'll go there in a minute. This is my garden. I don't have anything planted right now. These are my dew collectors. Get bottles of water. And yeah. This hatch I open up, and this goes down into my base. And I built all this, dug down to the ground, put up the walls, everything. And this is my base. Got the campfire, cement mixer, the forge, workbench, all that good stuff. All my other things, my inventory, I have them sorted out and labeled here. Drinks. The beer I don't use because it's useless to me. But yeah, that is it. And then I built this little living area over here. I put a bedroll down because that lets you know it's your territory, your base. So yeah. And then I built a bathroom over here. Little shower area. Yeah, apparently this server, all the bases get wiped on day 1000, so we've got 37 in-game days left to go, which I'm kind of ready for because I want to build something else. I want to build a giant hotel. Yeah, I enjoy this game, man. And I got a motorcycle if I want to ride around. Of course, you can pull up a map. There's my air, my home. Now, I did build a base before this one, but it kept glitching out, and trees would grow in the walls or destroy the walls. That was my first base right here. So I just moved all the way down here. Yeah, that is a little sneak peek of 7 days to die. Alright everyone, it is 10:54 p.m. and I think that's going to do it for this vlog. Probably going to go to bed in a little while, about another hour, and just to keep waking up to have to go to the bathroom. But yeah, I think we'll wrap it up for tonight. So this is basically how my days go by now. Nothing exciting at all. Insanely boring. Yeah. So anyway, on behalf of myself and Baby Bella, I hope you enjoyed this edition of the vlog. I might make this a weekly thing again. I don't know yet. We'll see. But hope y'all enjoyed it, and we'll see you on the next one. Y'all take care.